Hello everyone, welcome to CSIR Mathematics Tutorials. In this session, we will discuss problems of UGC CSIR NET Part A. Questions which are common for Mathematical Sciences, Earth Sciences and Chemical Sciences. Part A, General Aptitude Based Question. The first question which I am going to discuss is from June 2013. This is Lecture 2 of Number Based Question. I have already mentioned that Number Based Question series is on. So, this is the lecture number 2. The question from 2013 June. Suppose you expand the product x1 plus y1 multiplied with x2 plus y2 dot 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 up to x20 plus y20. How many terms will have only one x and rest y's? So, 4 options given: 1, 5, 10 and 20. So, after expansion of this, after taking product of all the terms, how many terms will have only one x and rest y? To explain this, I have expanded x1 plus y1. For example, x1 plus y1 multiplied with x2 plus y2 multiplied with x3 plus y3. I have already multiplied all these terms. We know two term here and two term here. So, in total we are aware of the rule that total 8 terms should be here after taking the actual product. So let us count 8 terms we have: 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So total 8 terms after taking product of these 3. Now what the question says, that how many terms will have only one x. So I have identified the terms where only one x. Only one x and rest all y. So only one x and rest all y. Only one x and rest all y. So we are aware that as the product is of x1 plus y1, x2 plus y2, x3 plus y3. So we will get like x1, y2, y3, x2. If 1 is there, then we will get y with 2 and 3 suffixes, y2, y3. If x2 will be there, then y1, y3. And if x3, then 3 is here. What suffixes will go to y? y1 and y2. These 3 terms we are going to get, which will have only 1x and rest all y. Remaining we can check here, all the 3x's. Here we can check 2x's and only 1y and so on. So only 3 terms will be such where only 1x and remaining 2y. Only 1x, remaining 2y. So this way, using this example, trying to make it clear, if we will take the product x1 plus y1 up to x20 plus y20, what will happen? If we understand it nicely, if we multiply like this, generalizing the result which we have got for x1 plus y1, x2 plus y2 into x3 plus y3, 3 terms like this where only 1x, generalizing the concept, we will get x1, y2, y3 dot 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 up to y20. Next will be like x2, y1, y3 dot 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 y20 and so on up to x20, where y will have suffixes y1, y2 dot 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 y90. Hope it is clear. So how many terms will be there? Exactly 20 terms will be such. Exactly 20 terms, 1, 2 and so on up to 20, exactly 20 terms will be such. There will be more terms in expansion which will have more than 1x terms. I am not saying these are the only terms which we will be getting. There will be more terms. We are not interested in why they will have more than one
x in every term. So only one x containing terms will be x1 into y2, y3 up to y20 and so on up to x20 into y1, y2 dot 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 y90. So exactly how many terms we will have? 20 terms. Such that, or which will contain, which will have only one x. Only one x. Rest y's. So hope it is clear. So correct option is given here, option D. We can see option D. So correct option is we will move ahead for next question. Next question is again from June 2013. What is the last digit of 7 raised to the power 73? Looks very simple, but it takes little time to understand it. What is the last digit of 7 raised to the power 73? Four options given: 7, 9, 3 and 1. So let us understand it clearly. If we take 7 raised to the power 1, as we are interested in 7 raised to the power 73 and it is really difficult to calculate the value of 7 raised to the power 73. So we will understand how it happens if we take the powers of 7, different powers of 7. So 7 raised to the power 1 is 7. If we multiply 7 again, 7 to the power 2 is 49. So we just interested and focusing on the last digit for all powers of 7. 7 cube gives last digit 3. 7 raised to the power 4 gives. Again, if we have to multiply 7, means 7 to the power 5. So 7 1 just 7. So last digit, even if we are not multiplying this much, just multiply 7 here and we will get 7 1 just 7. Means 7 last digit is going to be 7 for next power of 7. And so on. So 7 raised to the power 6. Means multiplying 7 here will give 7 7 of 49. So last digit will be 9 and so on. So what we see that after 4th power of 7, 5th power, 6th power is nothing but repetition of last digit. 7 again 6th power and 2nd power gives 9. Similarly 7th power will give last digit 3. And 8th power will give last digit 1 and again it will start repeating the same cycle. So finally these are the possible last digits 7, 9, 3, 1 which are given in the option 7, 9, 3, 1. What will be the last digit if the power is 7 raised to the power 73? So let us understand it more. So what? How can we categorize it? We can categorize it into four different parts, in four different sets. If we take power 1, then 5, and then after adding 4, that is 1, 5, 9, and so on, 1, 5, 9, 13. These powers of 7 will give last digit 7. Second power, 6th power, 10th power, 14th power and so on. All these powers of 7 will give last digit 9. Third power, 7th power of 7, 11th power, 15th power of 7 will give last digit 3. And fourth power, 8th power, 12th power, 16th power and so on. These powers of 7 will give last digit 1. So if we understand, if we come to know 73 will lie in which category, first category, second category, third category or fourth category, then immediately we can tell what will be the last digit because we are now very much aware of what can be the last digit if any power lies in any particular category. So just need to identify that. So what's happening here? question in each category 1, 5, 9, 13. There is gap of 1 plus 4, 5, 5 plus 4, 9, 9 plus 4, 13 and so on. Here also 2 plus 4, 6, 6 plus 4, 10, 10 plus 4, 14 and so on. In every category you will see that the difference 3 plus 4, 7, 4, 7 plus 4, 11, 11 plus 4, 15 and so on. Here also 4 plus 4, 8, table of 4. So what will happen if we divide 5, remainder will be same. Whatever number we take from this set, all will give remainder 1. Remainder will be same 1 when divided by 4. When we divide the power by 4. Similarly, when we divide these by 4, we are going to get 2 as remainder. When we divide these numbers, we are going to get 3 as remainders. And here we are going to get no remainder, 0 remainder. So let us divide 73. It means if we divide the power, the remainder will tell which category the number is going, the power is going to lie in. So if we divide 4, if we divide 73 by 4, then so remainder is how much? This is the remainder. The remainder is suggesting that 73 power will lie in this first category, in this first set of powers. So 73 will lie in first set, and the last digit, this set, the powers, these powers taken as power of 7 will give last digit 7. Hope it is clear what I am saying. If 73 gets divided by 4, the remainder is 1, and the remainder is telling in which set out of these 4 given sets, taken sets, which set 73 will lie in. So we found remainder 1 has suggested 73 will lie in the first category, first set of powers, which will give last digit 7. Hope it is clear, very simple concept. So 7 raised to the power 73 will give any number whose last digit will be nothing but 1. I'm sorry, last digit will be 7. Sorry. So 7 raised to the power 73 will give a number whose last digit will be 7. So this is the correct option. So answer is option A, 7 is the correct answer. So this way any number raised to power anything can be shorted out if the cycle is getting repeated. So we will be moving ahead for next problem. Next question we have is again from June 2013. We can see how many questions based on number only every time, every examination. If n is a natural number, if n raised to the power 5 is odd, which of the following is true? N is odd, n cube is odd. A option is given, n is odd. B, n cube is odd. And C says n raised to the power 4 is even. So out of 4 options we have to pick any one. A only correct. Which of the following is true? A only, B only, C only, and last option says A and B only. So very simple question. I think without taking any example, we can understand it. Still would like to explain it with one example. N raised to the power 5 is odd. So let us take n is equal to any even number. Suppose n is even. Suppose n is any even number. Even means 2 must be multiplied with any another number. It is already given natural number, so plus only, and natural number means starting from 1. Let us take n is given, so we can write n is equal to 2 into m. Now if we take n raised to the power 5, so what will happen? 2 raised to the power 5 into m raised to the power 5. Now 2 raised to the power 5, 32 into, so again 1, 2 is obviously there, we can write this 12 into 2 into. So this is again a even number. So if we start with an even number, if we take an even number, then n raised to the power 5 will essentially be an even number. That is very much clear to us. If we start with an even number and we take the power 5, we are going to get for sure an even number. So what it says, if n raised to the power 5 is odd, so n is odd. Yes, of course, if n raised to the power 5 is odd, then n must be odd. Because if we take an even number, then n raised to the power 5 is also even. So if n raised to the power 5 is already given odd, it must be odd. So this is correct. And if it is already clear that n is odd, what will happen with n raised to the power cube? Suppose n is odd, so any odd number, if we take power 3, any odd number you take power 3, suppose 5 raised to the power 3, so 5 125, so again an odd number only, right? So this is also correct. Now let us take n raised to the power 4, odd number, we take 4, so 625, again odd number, cannot be an even number. Anyways, we know this concept, so this is wrong. Very simple, n is odd, then only n to the power 5 will be odd, and thus n raised to the power 3 will also be odd, and n raised to the power 4 will also be odd, and so on. So any power of n cannot be even. So this option goes wrong. A and B correct. So we have this as option D. Which of the following is true? So D option, A and B only true. C is wrong option. So final answer would be option D. A and B. So this is the correct option. So we will see another problem. So next question is again from June 2013. And the question is, in solving a quadratic equation of the form x square plus ax plus b equal to 0, one student took the wrong value of a. And got roots 6 and 2. While another student took the wrong value of B and got roots 6 and 1. What are the correct value of A and values of A and B respectively? So 4 options given, 7, 12, 3, 4, minus 7, 12, 8, 12. Quadratic equation, we can quickly recall, we are very well aware, just few formulae in this section. So this is the equation which is given with us. Quadratic equation means highest power of variable is 2, then the equation is known as quadratic equation. So it will have two roots, means two solutions. So two students solved this given quadratic equation. One took wrong value of A. It is only mentioned took wrong value of A, it means B was correct, and got roots 6 and 2. Another student also solved and took wrong value of B, means value of A was correct, and got the roots 6 and 1. So what will be the correct values of A and B? So we have to get the values of A and B. We are aware that standard quadratic equation is of the form ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. where a can never be 0, a will never be 0. Let alpha and beta be two roots. As I mentioned, quadratic equation has two roots. So we name it alpha and beta, suppose. So sum of roots, we are aware, sum of roots is equal to minus b upon a. Coefficient of x upon coefficient of x square with minus sign, opposite sign. And product of the roots is equal to the number constant upon coefficient of x square, c upon a. This is what we know, alpha plus beta, sum of roots minus b by a, and alpha into beta c by a, where equation is taken like this. Now what equation is available with us will have to be checked. Now the given equation is x square plus ax plus b equal to 0. Be careful, let us compare these two equations. So a is equal to 1, b is equal to a, coefficient of x, and constant c is equal to b. So we will put all the values here now. So sum of roots is equal to minus b by a. So in place of b, I am writing this, and in place of a, 1. So a upon 1 is going to be a only, minus a only. Next is alpha into beta, product of roots c upon a. C is value is b, and a value is 1. So b upon 1 will again be written as b only. Fine. Now what is given here? One student took the wrong value of a. So took wrong value of a. So we'll clean it now further. Took wrong value of a. It means B was correct. Student 1 wrong value of A means alpha plus beta value is wrong, but wrong value of A and got root 6 and 2, but it is not given that wrong value of B also. So B value is correct and alpha beta, two roots we have is 6 and 2. So this is going to be correct because only a value is incorrect, b value is correct. So whatever alpha beta the student 1 has got will satisfy this condition. Will satisfy this condition, but will fail to satisfy this condition because a is taken wrong. So 6 into 2, b is equal to 6 into 2, that is b equal to 12. So student 1 will give correct value of b, which is product of roots 6 into 2, 12. So b is equal to 12. Now let us talk about student 2. If we think of this question with very calm mind, it's very simple question. Now another student took wrong value of b and got roots wrong value of b, but a is correct. So wrong value of b and got roots as 6 and 1. So student 2, alpha is 6, beta is equal to 1, given here alpha and beta. So alpha plus beta, this has to be correct for student 2. So alpha plus beta is equal to 6 plus 1 is equal to minus a. So minus a is equal to 7, hence a is equal to minus 7. So combining the results of student 1 and student 2, however both have made one mistake, but one correct answer both have given as per this question. So they are successful to give, one student is successful to give correct B value and another student helped to get correct value of A. This way, combining student 1 and 2 work, we got the final correct answer of A and B, which is given in the option C, minus 7 and 12. So the correct option is minus 7 and 12. Not only CSIR NET examination, but this question, all the competitive examination I have been observing, similar or even you can say just changing the digit, same type of question in most of the competitive examination starting from 10th standard. So please note it. We will be moving ahead for next question. Next question is from December 2013. Again a very simple question. If AI, BI, CI are different, how many terms will the expansion of the product contain? So 12, 30, 23 and 60, these are the four options given. How many terms the expansion of the product will contain? We are aware, suppose we have three terms here. Inside first parenthesis, first bracket, second bracket contains four terms and the third one contains five terms. When these will be multiplied, there will be how many terms in the product? So this is a simple concept. Just multiply how many terms each bracket has. Just multiply the number of terms. That many terms the expansion of the product will contain. What I am trying to say, suppose there are two terms, three terms, then how many terms, suppose A plus B into C plus D plus E, then how many terms will the product have? So, 2 terms here and 3 terms here. So, total 2 into 3, 6 terms will be here. This we can verify also. AC, AD, AE, 3 terms. BC, BD, BE, 3 terms. So, total 6 terms. This is a simple counting principle we call it. That how many terms here? 3 terms, 4 terms, 5 terms. So, we multiply number of terms and we will get how many terms going to be there after expansion or after taking the actual product. So 60 terms will be there. So the final answer is, sometimes questions are very easy and it doesn't even take 1 minute, less than 1 minute. So correct option is D, 60 terms will be there in the expansion of this product. So let us see the next problem. So next question here is again from December 2013. Look at the question. 25 divided by 5 plus 3 minus 2 into 4 inside a bracket, and then plus 16 into 4 minus 3 another bracket. Four options: 61, 22, 41 upon 25 upon is B1. So clearly clear it is that the problem is based on Bodmer's rule. So we just need to recall what Bodmer's rule is. However, all of us so bracket B for brackets, first priority will be given to brackets, first brackets will be shorted out off. This is divide, then multiplication, then addition, after that subtraction, last priority is given for subtraction. Divide, bracket means this type of brackets are given, then whatever is inside bracket with that needs to be sorted out first. After off, like 15% of 20, this type of things if appear, we have to short it out first. Divide we know, multiply, we know addition and subtraction. So this way hierarchy is given. First of all, this will be given priority, then off type of things will be given priority, third priority to division, then multiplication and addition and subtraction. Anything left? All done. So using this concept, we will be shorting out. So bracket, so this needs to be sorted out first, and then this needs to be sorted out first. So we have now, and inside this bracket, off is not available, divide. Divide, we can find that divide is here. So very first we will solve this division. So 25 divided by 5 is how much? 5 plus 3 minus 2 into 4. And here in this bracket division is not there, off is not there, off is not there, division not this, direct multiplication. So we can multiply. So 16 into 4 is 64 minus 3. Now next step, again addition, subtraction and multiplication. So multiplication will be done before addition and subtraction. So let us multiply these two. So now first we will do this as per Bodmer's rule. So we multiply, then we get. Now we can subtract because we have only in this bracket we are left with 64 minus 3. Only one operation is left, subtraction. So we can 61, and then the bracket goes off because the work is done. Entire processing has been done, so bracket can be removed. Now here addition and subtraction, again we can see that addition comes before subtraction. So let us add first. So 5 plus 3 will be 8 minus 8 and plus 61. We will put the bracket because still the work is not done. Now 8 minus 8 will give 0 and 0 plus 61. So finally we get the answer 61. So is it available in the option list? Yes. You know, sometimes Bodmer's rule also we go wrong. So we need to be careful. A 61 first option is correct option. So done with this problem. Let's move ahead for another question. Next question is also from December 2013. The question is 4 raised to the power 0 plus 4 raised to the power 2 plus 1 upon 4 raised to the power 2 plus 1 upon 4 raised to the power half equals. The four options are given. Looks very difficult, but let us solve it and then we will see which option is matching with the answer. So we have 4 raised to the power 0 plus 4 square plus 1 upon 4 square plus 1 upon 4 raised to the power half. Now this can be 4 to the power 0, finite number raised to the power 0, non-zero finite number raised to the power 0 is 1, 4 square is 16, 1 upon 4 square, that is 1 upon 16. And if we look at it, this is 1 upon square root of 4. 4 raised to the power half means what? 4 raised to the power half means square root of 4. Further, if we solve it, we can add these to 17 plus 1 upon 16, and this is 2. So we taking LCM, we get 16. So this is 1 and this is 8. So we have 17 plus 9 upon 16. 1 minute, if anything left in the question. 4 raised to the power 0 or the 1 upon 4 square, 4 raised to the power half. Here one thing is missing, 4 raised to the power half, because I was not getting answer 17 plus, so 4 raised to the power half was missing, sorry. So 4 raised to the power half also, so this is nothing but square root of 4. So square root of 4, further we will add it here 2. So 17 plus 2 is 19. So we have 19 plus 9 upon 16. So 19 plus 9 upon 16 can be further written as, we know we can write it as mixed fraction, which will be written as 19 9 upon 16. What does it mean? 19 into 16 plus 9. This is exactly what this will become. If we will take, make it common denominator, this will also become 19 into 16 plus 9 whole divided by 16. So this can be exactly written as mixed fraction like this, 19 9 upon 16, which is given in the option C. So correct option we have is option C. So correct option we have got, 4 raised to the power half was missing. Please include it. So we will be moving ahead for next problem. So the next question is again from December 2013. For real numbers x and y, x square plus y minus 5 raised to the power 2 is equal to 0. Then the value of x plus y is, then the value of x plus y is 0, 2, root 2 and 4. Given x raised to the power 2 plus y minus 4 raised to the power 2 equal to 0. So we will move ahead with this and finally we will try to get that value x plus y. Very, very easy question. So look at it, x square plus y minus 4 whole square equal to 0. What's special here? Square of any number here and square of any number here and addition. We are very well aware square of any number becomes a positive quantity. So if we add a positive quantity here, if we add two positive quantities and getting 0, this is possible only when this quantity here, suppose t1 I am saying and t2, this is only possible when t1 is 0 and t2 is also 0. So what I am saying, that square of any number becomes positive quantities, and if we add two positive quantities cannot become 0 until and unless they are compulsorily both 0. So it means that x will be 0 and y minus 4 will also be separately 0, both 0 at a time. Then only their squares and addition of their squares becoming 0. The condition, only condition, possible condition is x 0 and y minus 4 also 0. Hope the concept is clear. So thus we have got the value of x and y without expanding it. We don't have to expand it. The terms inside square will be separately 0 if the addition of squares becoming 0. So x equal to 0, y equal to 4. What value we have to calculate is x plus y. So putting the value 0 plus 4, so 4. This option is given here as option D. So correct answer is answer. I think it did not take even 1 minute. Few seconds are sufficient to sort it out. So this way we see that part A questions also we can attempt and crack easily if we have done enough practice. So I'll be back with next lecture number 3 with more problems based on numbers, part A, general aptitude, common for mathematical, earth sciences and chemical sciences. So keep watching, keep sharing my videos, and if you like my videos, please subscribe the channel. Thank you very much.